Hello everyone, welcome to StudyIQ. In this video, I will bring to you the current affairs for 16th of December. So without further ado, let's start the video. Who has been named as the 2018 International Tennis Federation World Champions? So it was different for male and female, and for male, it is Novak Djokovic. He is from Serbia. As for female, Simona Halep. Simona Halep won this award. ITF World Champion. So remember both of their names, and this is very important. In case they ask you, Simona Halep is from which country? She is from Romania. And also remember, there was another tournament which was called ATP World Tour Finals. So in ATP Finals, the men's title was won by Alexander Zverev. So I repeat, ATP Finals was won by Alexander Zverev, and ITF World Champion in tennis is Novak Djokovic in men's. He is from Serbia, and Simona Halep from Romania in women's. What is the name of that exercise that is launched by the Indian Coast Guard in Odisha to protect the endangered olive ridley turtle? Olive ridley turtles are one of the hallmarks of Odisha. In fact, in most of the tournaments also, the Oli is a mascot, and that is in fact olive ridley turtle. In Odisha, you will find olive ridley turtle at two places. One is Rishikulya Beach, and then you will also find in Gahirmat Beach. Gahirmat in fact is a wildlife sanctuary also. This is called Operation Oliva. Scientists of which country, they have developed the world's first vaccine to protect honeybees against disease? First of all, when we rear honeybees for, you know, different items like bee wax or honey, different items are obtained from honeybees. That is called apiculture. And when we rear silkworms, it is called sericulture. So don't confuse between apiculture and sericulture. Now the question is, scientists of which country, they have developed world's first vaccine to protect honeybees against disease? This has been done by the scientists from Finland. Now, how will this vaccine be administered into honeybees? Of course, you can't give injection to honeybees. So therefore, they have developed a sort of a sugar lump, you know, and just as the children, small children are given polio vaccines in the form of drops, honeybees will also be fed these sugar lumps and the vaccine will go into their body. National Medical Devices Promotion Council will be set up under which ministry? Now, this is an important question. National Medical Devices Promotion Council is a separate organization that will be set up, and it will work under the Ministry of Commerce and Industry, right now headed by Suresh Prabhu, who is also the Civil Aviation Minister. Now, who will be the chairman of National Medical Devices Promotion Council? So, the Department of Industrial Policy and Promotion Secretary, you know, the person who will be the secretary in the Department of Industrial Policy and Promotion will automatically or ex officio become the chairman of the National Medical Devices Promotion Council. And Department of Industrial Policy and Promotion also works under the Ministry of Commerce and Industry. Which country will choose a word diverse for the third gender on birth certificate? So while registration of the birth certificate, there will be three options: male, female, and diverse. We are talking about Germany. Which are the top two oil selling countries to India? Oil is sold by mostly the OPEC countries, which are headquartered in Vienna. Now, can you tell me, one country has recently quit OPEC? Which country is that? Can you tell me? Write down in comments. The two top selling countries, number one is Iraq. Okay. Number two is Saudi Arabia. Number three is United Arab Emirates. Iran has now been pushed to sixth position because of the sanctions and pressure from America. Number five in India's case is Nigeria. Actually, Venezuela, and then we have Nigeria. So actually these rankings keep on changing, right? These rankings keep on changing. So for example, for the month of November, if I tell you, Iraq was number one, Saudi Arabia was number two. So the answer to this question in any case will remain A and C. However, for the month of November, UAE was third, okay? And fourth position was occupied by Venezuela. Nigeria was fifth, and then Iran was sixth. Anyways, top two are Iraq and Saudi Arabia. According to SIPRI, what is SIPRI? This is a very, very important organization. Stockholm International Peace Research Institute. And Stockholm is the capital of Sweden. So according to Stockholm International Peace Research Institute, how many Indian companies, they all are government sector, they have been featured in the world's top 100 arms producers in 2017. Only four Indian companies have made it to this list. Which are these four? So Indian Ordnance Factory, it is at 37th position. Then Hindustan Aeronautics, it is at 38th position. And Bharat Electronics is at 64th position. And Bharat Dynamics is at 94th position. So these are the four companies. But you should absolutely know which are the top 10 arms producers in the world. So Lockheed Martin is number one. It is an American company. In fact, top six are all American companies. Boeing, Raytheon, BAE Systems, Northrop Grumman, and General Dynamics. Then we have a French company, Airbus. Thales, again French company. Leonardo, Italian, and Almazante of Russia. One more company that you should know is Dassault Aviation, because we will get Rafale from Dassault, and Rafale, you know, they are accusing that it is a scam. So if reports are to go by, it is a huge scam. So that company is Dassault Aviation. Also worth remembering is a company called Embraer. Embraer is a company from Brazil. And then there is another company called Bombardier. It is a Canadian company. So you should know all the companies that manufacture arms or commercial aircrafts or fighter aircrafts. Which minister has introduced the Dam Safety Bill in the Lok Sabha? Dam Safety Bill has been introduced by the Minister of State for Parliamentary Affairs and also for Water Resources. His name is Arjun Ram Meghwal. Now recently we have a new Parliamentary Affairs Minister. Can you tell me who is he? Write down his name in comments. The government has constituted a 7-member committee to select the managing director of all the public sector insurance companies like NIACL, UICL, LIC and all that. Now the managing director of these companies will be selected by a panel, and who will be the chairman of that? The chairman will be Mr. BP Sharma. Do you know who is BP Sharma? BP Sharma is the chairman of the Bank's Board Bureau, and he is also the chairman of this committee, which will in turn appoint the managing director of the government owned insurance companies in India. National award winning film director Mr. Topil Ajayan, he passed away. He belonged to which regional cinema? He belonged to Malayali cinema. He belonged to Malayali cinema, which is the official film industry, Kerala. 21st National Athletics Sports Championship for the Blind was held where? And there were all sorts of events like javelin, discus, 100 meter race, everything was there. And it took place in Delhi. So the answer is Delhi. The actress, she was once nominated for Oscar for the movie The Heart is a Lonely Hunter. What was her name? She passed away recently. And this movie came in 1968. Her name was Sandra Locke. Sandra Locke. Who has been appointed as the next ambassador of India to the Republic of Guinea? The next ambassador of India to Republic of Guinea is Mr. T.C. Barupal. Who has been elected as the new president of FTII, Film and Television Institute of India? Earlier, Anupam Kher was the president, but he resigned. The new president is Brijender Pal Singh. In case you don't know who is he, so he, you know, Mr. Brijender Pal Singh, he was the deputy of Anupam Kher, that is, he was the vice chairperson of FTII. And he is also the producer of CID, you know, Crime Investigation Department. CID is a very popular show in North India on Sony TV. And I don't know whether it still is active or not, but I think for around 20 years, CID entertained the masses. 23rd International Film Festival of Kerala was held in which city? So International Film Festival of India was in Goa, and International Film Festival of Kerala was in capital Thiruvananthapuram. Now also remember that the best film award was given to the movie called The Dark Room. And the Lifetime Achievement Award was given to the legendary director from Iran, Mr. Majid Majidi. Mr. Majid Majidi from Iran was given the Lifetime Achievement Award at the International Film Festival of Kerala. 3 times Grammy Award winner. She was a jazz singer. So music has various genres like pop, rock, jazz, and you know many others. She was popular in jazz. And she was 3 times Grammy Award winner. What was her name? In fact, the trophy that she is holding is the Grammys. Her name was Nancy Wilson. She passed away recently. Who has been appointed as the next High Commissioner of India to the Republic of Mauritius? Mauritius' capital is Port Louis. Mauritius is a very good friend of India. And Praveen Jagannath is the head of state of Mauritius. So Mr. Tanmay Lal will be the High Commissioner of India to Mauritius. Which is the largest nuclear power station in India? The largest capacity is 1400 megawatt. It is Tarapur. It is in Maharashtra. Jaitapur is also in Maharashtra, Kundankulam is in Tamil Nadu, and Kaiga is in Karnataka. According to the census of 2011, which state in India has the best or the highest sex ratio? Highest sex ratio is in Kerala. For every 1000 male, Kerala had 1084 females. So it had the highest sex ratio. And if I talk about the union territories, then Pondicherry. Pondicherry had 1037 females for every 1000 males in 2011. The headquarter of World Tourist Organization, WTO, World Tourism Organization, is where? It is in Madrid. Madrid is the capital of Spain. So the answer is D. So this was the video for 16th of December. We are moving quite fast, and now we are left with current affairs for only 10 to 15. That is 6 videos are remaining for Hindi and English, and I'll upload those very, very soon, probably today itself. So do check out our sale also. We are running the second biggest sale of the year. That is the Christmas sale. It will run till 25th of December. And some great discounts are available on some of the best-selling courses. If you want more details, do check out the website studyiq.com. Thank you so much and take care.